Some people dream of making babies. Some dream of making baby universes. Seriously? Yes, seriously. How's that supposed to work? What does it take to make a new universe? And if we make one, what do we do with it? That's what we'll talk about today. At first sight, it seems impossible to make a new universe, because where would you take all that stuff from, if not from the old universe? But it turns out you don't need a lot of stuff to make a new universe. And we know that from Albert Einstein. Yes, that guy again. First, Albert Einstein famously taught us that mass is really just a type of energy, E equals mc square and all that. But more importantly, Einstein also taught us that space is dynamic. It can bend and curve, and it can expand. It changes with time. And if space changes with time, then energy is not conserved. I explained this in more detail in an earlier video, but here's the brief summary. The simplest example of energy non-conservation is the cosmological constant. The cosmological constant is the reason that the expansion of our universe gets faster. It has units of an energy density, so that's energy per volume, and as the name says, it's constant. But if the energy per volume is constant and the volume increases, then the total energy increases with the volume. This means in an expanding universe, you can get a lot of energy from nothing if you just manage to expand space rapidly enough. I know that this sounds completely crazy, but this is really how it works in Einstein's theory of general relativity. Energy is just not conserved. So, okay, we don't need a lot of matter, but how do we make a baby universe that expands? Well, you try to generate conditions similar to those that created our own universe. There is a little problem with that, which is that no one really knows how our universe was created in the first place. There are many different theories for it, but none of them has observational support. However, one of those theories has become very popular among astrophysicists. It's called eternal inflation. And while we don't know it's right, it could be right. In eternal inflation, our universe is created from the decay of a force vacuum. To understand what a force vacuum is, let's first talk about what a true vacuum is. A true vacuum is in a state of minimal energy. You can't get energy out of it. It's stable. It just sits there. Because it already has minimal energy, it can't do anything and you can't do anything with it. A false vacuum is one that looks like a true vacuum temporarily, but eventually it decays into a true vacuum because it has energy left to spare. And that extra energy goes into something else. For example, if you throw jelly at a wall, it'll stick there for a moment, but then fall down. That moment when it sticks to the wall is kind of like a false vacuum state. It's unstable and it will eventually decay into the true vacuum, which is when the jelly drops to the ground and the extra energy splatters it all over the place. What does this have to do with the creation of our universe? Well, consider you have a lot of force vacuum. In that force vacuum, there's a patch that decays into a true vacuum. The true vacuum has a lower energy, but it can have higher pressure. If it has higher pressure, it'll expand. That's how our universe could have started. And in principle, you can recreate this situation in the laboratory. You just have to create this false vacuum state. Then part of it will decay into a true vacuum, and if the conditions are right, that true vacuum will expand rapidly. While it expands, it creates its own space. It does not grow into our universe, it makes a bubble. This universe creation only works if you have enough energy or mass in the original blob of force vacuum. How much do you need? Depends on some of the parameters of the model, which physicists don't know for sure, but in the most optimistic case, it's about 10 kilograms. That's what it takes to make a new universe. 10 kilograms. But how do you create 10 kilograms of force vacuum? No one has any idea. Also, 10 kilograms might not sound much if you're a rocket scientist, but for particle physicists, that's a terrible lot. the mass equivalent that even the presently biggest particle collider, the Large Hadron Collider, works with is 10 to the minus 20 grams. Now, if you collide big atomic nuclei instead of protons, you can bring this up by some orders of magnitude. But 10 kilograms is not something that high-energy physicists will work with in my lifetime. No one will create a new universe anytime soon. But well, in principle, theoretically, we could do it if you believe this story with the false vacuum and so on. Let us just suppose for a moment that this is correct. What would we do with these universes? Would we potty train them and send them to cosmic kindergarten? Well, no, because sadly, these little baby universes don't stay connected to their mother universe for long. Their connection is like a wormhole throat. It becomes unstable and pinches off within a fraction of a second. So you'd be giving birth to these universes, kickstart their growth, but then, bloop, they're gone. From the outside, they would look pretty much like small black holes. By the way, this could be happening all the time without particle physicists doing anything, because we don't really understand the quantum properties of space. So some people think that space really makes a lot of quantum fluctuations. These fluctuations happen at distances so short we can't see them, but it could be that sometimes they create one of these baby universes. If you want to know more about this topic, Zia Mairali has a very nice book about baby universes called A Big Bang in a Little Room. This video was sponsored by NordVPN. NordVPN is an app that keeps you safe as you browse the internet. You install it on your phone or laptop, use it to connect to one of their servers, and then browse the web from there. This keeps your data safe, even on a public wireless. NordVPN has more than 5,000 servers all over the world and allows you to choose your location from any one of them. So if you ever encounter a video or website that is blocked where you are, you can just connect to a different server in a different country and access the website from there. Viewers of this channel can now benefit from a special offer with a huge discount if you use the link nordvpn.com/Sabine and the coupon code Sabine. NordVPN works on pretty much any platform, Android, Windows, iOS, what have you. Once again, that's nordvpn.com/Sabine and the coupon code Sabine. Thanks for watching. See you next week.